Dom from Adobe here. I'm super excited to show you this new project from Adobe Research using generative AI to co-create music. Let's go check it out. What's up, Nick?
How you doing, Dom?
Pretty good. I heard you got a new project cooking up.
Yeah, I've been working on some music co-creation with precise control. I can take an input melody that sounds like this. And then you can generate the accompaniment, in this case, some film music.
That's cool. That's just from a prompt?
Yeah, yeah. Do you want to hear something else?
Yeah, let's do hip hop.
All right, one sec.
Okay.
Check out this other example where I can control the intensity up or down.
Oh yeah, no, that was intense.
Did you write any songs?
Yeah, I actually do make music.
What type of songs you write?
I like to write love songs.
Love songs? All right. I got some R&B music.
R&B music, okay.
With a little chorus verse intro type thing. Yeah, take a listen.
Okay, yeah, I could definitely hear the difference between the chorus and the beginning of the song. And it generated that by itself?
Yeah.
That's dope.
Yeah.
What about loops? I need loops all the time for my videos.
We can generate loops just from a text prompt. Take a listen to this.
That's cool, man. So sometimes I have videos, but the music isn't long enough. Do you have a solution for that?
Yeah, check this out. I can take this classical piece of music and make it longer. All right, now here's the lengthened one.
That's cool. It created a whole different sequence for it. So what else can you do with this?
Oh, you can actually combine all these things together. So I can, for example, take the length extension and also fade it out.
And fade out. A lot of people think generative AI is only for images, but Adobe Research is breaking new ground on audio too, making tools that are accessible for everyone.